I'm going to start talking today about how find and replace works in brackets. I'm working in my demo project and I discovered while planning this lesson that I need to fix something in my HTML. The selecting code section of shortcuts has the wrong descriptions. If you're following along, you may not have this problem because it is correct in the original gist I used. If you do, you can recopy the selection shortcuts again. I'll use the find command to find the selecting section. The shortcut is Ctrl+F, which is pretty standard for most applications. I can type selecting and it will take me to the correct spot. I don't have to hit enter. It takes me there as I'm typing. I'll paste the correct content. And then I'll indent. Next, I'll copy the second gist, which is the shortcuts for find and replace. I want to put that at the end of the main div. The differences in the keyboard shortcuts for find and replace on the different operating systems are more complex than just swapping command and control keys. So I think it's time to separate out the shortcuts so each operating system has its own page. I'd like to copy the PC page to a Mac page. I'll do a save as Mac HTML. Notice that my live preview is showing Mac HTML now, since that's what's open. I'm going to add the word Mac to the title tag and also to the H1 so it's obvious which page we're on at any time. Also, I can delete the PC shortcut sections where I created two groups of shortcuts for each operating system. I'll do a find on PC to find them. If I type PC, it's telling me it's finding three matches in the panel. If I click on the match case button, it finds zero, so I'll turn that back off. I'll hit escape to close the panel, then I can delete this section of PC shortcuts. Now I want to find the next one. Unfortunately, brackets does not remember my previous search, which I think is the biggest flaw in their implementation of find and replace. I do believe they're working on saving previous searches, however, so hopefully we'll see that in a future release. If I search again, I find the word PC was used in a note, so I'll leave that. Now the page is clean and ready to be updated to show correct Mac shortcuts. For the majority of the shortcuts, I want to swap the word control with command. Instead of doing a find, I want to use replace. On Windows, the command is Ctrl+H. On a Mac, the command is Cmd+Alt+F. And when I say Alt, I mean the Option key. Remember, you can find the correct shortcut always under the Find menu. So now that I have the Replace panel showing, I can type Control in the first box and Command in the second. It's found 33 instances of Control. I don't want to blindly replace every one of these because a few actually do use the Control key. So one thing I could do is hit the Replace button to change them one by one while seeing them on the screen before I replace it down here. If I hover over the button, I see the shortcut showing, so I can use that instead of hitting the button. If you want to skip an instance, you can hit the next button right here to skip it. When I hover over that, I see the shortcut, and I could use that as well. I do actually want to change that one, so I can go back with the previous button or the correct shortcut. I could go through the entire file this way, picking and choosing what I want to update. It wouldn't be the worst way to proceed, depending on how many matches you have. However, the batch button is faster when you have a lot to replace. When I click on it, it opens a new panel below and shows me everywhere that the word was found. It's highlighting the word so I can see it on each line. I can drag the panel to resize if necessary. If I click on a line down there, it will take me to that spot in the code. That can be helpful when you want to decide if it needs to be changed or not. There are a few places I don't want to replace the control with command. I can find them and uncheck those lines. Ctrl+L is correct on both operating systems, so I will uncheck that one. The scroll up and down shortcuts right above it are Mac specific as well. Now if I click on replace, it will update all except for those three at once. There are a few shortcuts still that I need to fix for the Mac, and a replace command won't really work, so I'll just find them and fix them. The block comment shortcut is not Cmd+Shift+/, but Cmd+Alt+/. And moving a line or selection up or down involves Cmd+Ctrl+ the arrow keys instead of Cmd+Shift and the arrow keys. As I mentioned already, the find and replace shortcuts are another area where the shortcuts differ somewhat drastically by operating system. If we look at that section in the live preview, you can see that I have separated the shortcuts by a pipe symbol, with the Windows shortcuts showing first and the Mac shortcuts after the pipe. I'll delete the Windows version of the shortcuts on this page. So, if you're unfortunate like me and work on both operating systems, keeping track of some of these shortcuts can be confusing. That's part of the reason I'm creating these cheat sheets. I still need to update the pc.html file and remove any Mac references in there. I won't make you watch me do that, but if you want to see the code when I'm done, you can check out the link to the endpoint in the lesson notes. I do want to point out that you can search using regular expressions. If I click on this button with a period and asterisk, it will do a regular expression search. Let's say I wanted to find all my shortcuts inside the strong tags. I can type the strong tag, then \+ to match all characters after it on the line, and then finish with a closing strong tag. It's finding 65 of these, and if I hit F3 or Command-G on a Mac, I can find them all to look at them. Also notice, if you look at the scroll bar, you can see the gold lines, and they're indicating matches. That is a nice feature that isn't available in all text editors. I haven't talked about find and replace across multiple files yet, but I will do that in the next lesson.